We are trying to do things in a better and more efficient way so that we can give the people a higher level of service, a level of service to which the people aspire and to which you, the people of Trinidad and Tobago, are entitled. Okay. You have also to take into account another decision that the government took. And it is this, on the basis of harsh experience, that the public service is an administration and not an executing agency. That is to say, the public service administers programs. It cannot carry out the execution function itself. The Ministry of Works is able to set up arrangements to construct highways. The Ministry of Works should not be constructing highways itself. Understand? It is inefficient in doing that. That is more efficiently done by private organizations. I could name several of them. So therefore, what we are saying is, those who are able to do it better, let them do it. So if the private sector is the most efficient way of building roads in the country, let the private sector build the roads. Let the Ministry of Works administer it. Make sure it sets the standards and so make sure things are going well. So the public service is an administration and not an executing agency. One of the problems that we have experienced with the public service, my dear friends, that makes it inefficient is the fact that the authority to hire and fire does not reside with the public service. So that in the local government reform, what we have done, we have removed the local government bodies from the ambit of the public service. We set up corporations, as we set up the RHAs, as we set up any one of the corporations, CPEPO, any one of them. They are no corporations. And because they are corporations, they will be given an HR department, a human resource department, and they'll be given the authority to hire and fire up to a certain level. The chief executive officer and the heads of all departments must not be able to be touched by them. However, the CEO and the department heads must be employed by the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Local Government. What that does is this. Ask any local government councillor. Right now, you have a situation where CEOs don't take on councils, you know, because you can't touch them. You can't touch them, and therefore they don't take you on. You don't want a situation where you are putting the technical people directly in the hands of the politicians. You don't want that either. So what the government is recommending is that those top positions are handled by the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Local Government. And if a council has a problem with a CEO, any one of the top officers, a report is made to the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Local Government, and that permanent secretary investigates it and decides what has to be done. In other words, CEOs will now understand that you are not a law unto yourself, and that the notion of independence that you have could never be a notion that is used to the disadvantage of the people who are supposed to benefit from your own stewardship. All of this is public service reform, eh? All of this is public service reform impinging only indirectly for the time being on the local government bodies, but that last one was direct. Yes. We have also taken another decision, and that is to establish administrative regions so that we can decentralize central government functions. Am I giving you too much tonight? All right. We're not getting directly to local government, not tonight, because it is clear that we have a lot to do. The administrative regions, the boundaries of the administrative regions as they now stood, well, as you would have known them, St. Andrew, St. David, St. George, St. Patrick, Victoria, and so on. Remember, Nero? Those used to be the administrative regions. What we are now saying is that the new administrative regions must have boundaries that are the same boundaries as local government, coterminous with local government boundaries as we describe it. So for every two local government boundaries, for every two local government bodies, you have one region, except in two cases, which is Tunapuna Piako, which is very large, and San Fernando because of where it is located. So we will end up with seven administrative regions for 12 local government bodies. One of the advantages of that, my dear friends, is that the local government bodies can now be given a responsibility to to monitor the execution of government decisions at the local level so that the Ministry of Works or the Ministry of Education establishes itself along the lines of the administrative regions, but the local government bodies, two of them, monitor what the Ministry of Education, the Ministry of Works does within their own areas. They know what the program is because they discussed that at the beginning of the year. And they monitor what they're doing. And if they're not happy, they could talk to them. Well, I mean, you say you're going to do this, this hasn't happened, and so on and so on. A monitoring and evaluation machinery, the effect of which is to ensure to a greater extent a higher level of execution of the decisions that the government takes at the local level. So there you go. So my dear friends, all of these things that I've talked about are based on the need for efficiency and integrity. So that as we consider local government, we have to consider all of those things, the size of Trinidad and Tobago, decentralization versus devolution, the need to set up administrative regions, the need to recognize that the public service is an administration and not an executing agency, the power to hire and fire, the recognition of a decision to set up a roads and drainage authority, a revenue authority, a development control authority, and so on and so on and so on. The local government bodies, therefore, where they will have a big responsibility is in maintenance. Maintenance. And when we meet in the College of Harris Promenade next week, Monday, we will go into the actual responsibilities of local government. Just want to deal with one of them now, which is maintenance. Because you see, there has been some kind of overlap as between the responsibilities of CPEP and the local government bodies. There has been some overlap between CPEP and local government bodies. What is going to happen? How do we see that operating? The staff of the local government bodies will be converted into companies, my dear friends, into companies, and given contracts with the local government bodies to maintain drains and the environment. CPEP will be given the same responsibility. In other words, we're going to look at the whole country. And where there is not a CPEP program, we will ensure that the existing workers in the local government bodies are put into companies and given some responsibility for the execution of the maintenance function. They will landscape areas, they cut grass, they keep the drains clear, and so on and so on and so on. And by that mechanism, for the first time, my dear friends, in the history of Trinidad and Tobago, we are going to have a mechanism that we believe stands an excellent chance of working well and stands an excellent chance of giving you the level of service to which you legitimately aspire. And there's one other point in this matter. We have four other special purpose state enterprises. We have East Port of Spain Development Company, Community Improvement Services Limited, Palo Seco Agricultural Enterprises Limited, and the Rural Development Corporation. All four of them doing the same thing in different parts of the country. What effectively they are supposed to be doing is going into a community, talking with the residents, identifying all that has to be done, doing everything as they did in the pilot program in Coquille Village South, and then coming out. And what we are saying is that we are now of the view that these four companies should be amalgamated into one company. They should be tasked by the Ministry of Local Government. They go into an area, they fix up everything, and then they hand that area to the local government body to be maintained. That's how we can have a local government system, but it cannot be the same local government system that you will have in London with a large population. It cannot be the same local government system that you will have in New York with a very large population. It cannot be the same local government system that you have in Miami with a very large population. It has to be a local government system which, while looking at other systems around the world and trying to identify from those systems things that are good and that might be relevant for us, it has to be a local government system that is unique to Trinidad and Tobago.